Let there be light. What's going on, guys? Welcome back.
Let me run you through the seasonings real quick. Nice knowing you.
Cheers.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode. We're here with the fam. We're on another camping mission. We're beating the sunlight. Stay tuned. We'll get you around the campfire.
Let there be light.
Bang. Bang, bang.
Hallelujah.
We've got flame. It took us a minute. We got here pretty late tonight, so we're still setting up camp. It's my brother Andy, AKA Ans.
Yeah.
AKA Ans, link in description. I didn't know if it was going to be Uncle Ans. That's your Instagram, right?
It is.
Uncle Ans or Ans on YouTube.
That's true.
We've got Miss Lauren in the tent setting up. And then we've got two more special guests that y'all need to meet here. They're finishing unloading right now. This is going to be a camping trip with the boys, aka my brothers.
We got a ton of stuff tonight with the big 8-person tent.
Put up flawlessly, might I add. Not a single hiccup.
Hey, you want to give us some insight on that?
well, we put up the tent, and there may or may not be two extra poles lying in the bag right now. It's a good enough mindset.
Good enough?
Yeah.
All right, guys, here's my little brother, Grayson. Grayson, say what's up to the vlog.
What's up?
All right. How old are you, Gray?
12.
What grade are you going into?
7th.
Atta babe.
How's it going, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Gavin Neal. I'm 16, and I helped build this fire.
I couldn't be further from the truth. He went on a firewood run and came back with 2 pine cones. So
three pine cones.
There you go. All right, guys, we have set up the camp. Got everything situated. This is the old-fashioned original Coleman grill. This thing is 30 years old and it's still kicking. You already know what's in the bin. Camera kit, brother on the grind.
Yeah.
At Ann's.
Oh, I feel you.
And, we're just going to be chillaxing around this fire. We're going to get dinner started soon. And when we do, I'll let you guys know and I'll wake you guys up for the dinner preparation, all right? All right, guys, it is dinner time. We are getting the kitchen prepared on the old Coleman. And we are getting everything prepared here. I'm going to throw you guys up on the head mount and you guys see what we got going on in the kitchen. We're going to get cheeseburgers with grilled onions and raw onions. Who wants grilled and who wants raw?
Grilled.
3 grilleds, no onions for low, and I will take raw onion. So that's what we got going on the Coleman.
How many do we got total?
We got 2 of these ones, and then we've got 6 other in the bag.
I don't think you know how to cut onions.
It's not a good knife, and I'm not skilled on cutting onions. You're right, brother. Got some seasonings here. Everybody okay with salt and pepper?
The fire that it was hot. Really, 2 waffles?
Actually,
Kai, you're looking great.
Thank you.
Amazing.
I've been working at a deli for about 2 months, and at the deli, we cut our avocados. So this is, you want to get around, oh, my light's gone, cut all the way around. And depending on how much avocado, I think I'm going to use 1/4 on mine. Obviously, there you go. Cut.
You did that for a living?
Okay, then you're gonna cut this in half and then peel this off. This is a very ripe avocado. Okay, hands gotta get dirty, but that's okay. So from here, you hold it in your hand, just slice.
We got the waffle.
Blueberry
burger.
Waffles.
That's pretty good.
Do you.
All right, guys, we got the grilled onions ready to go. Since it's on the old Coleman, these two spots are the hottest. All right, my brother's doing a little waffle burger. It's not the craziest thing I've ever seen, but I wouldn't recommend it. Slap the cheese on there for him. Brother thinks it's meat juice. It's blood.
Wait, so you're telling me all these years that's been...
Yep. Can you queso chip me?
Yeah, I got you. Is it warm?
Queso and burger thoughts.
Mmm.
I was hoping it was good.
Bro, who's going to put queso on their burger?
Not it.
That might sound good.
I'm going to my boy Gavin on the waffle burger, mainly because I want to see this experiment. Yeah. Which side?
Onions.
Honestly, it looks beautiful, don't it? Mm. All right, y'all, we're here with Grayson here.
I got ketchup, avocado, and a little bit of queso.
Here you go, brother. You. On this side?
Yep.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Enjoy. Oh, we forgot the onions.
Oh, onions.
You want onions too, Drew?
Oh, yeah.
On top of the avocado.
I seemed way too excited for onions on a burger. Can I take that take again?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right, there you go. Enjoy. All right, y'all, we're here with Andy, a.k.a. Ans, a.k.a. Uncle Ans.
I'm embarrassed to show my burger because all the other, like, I'm supposed to be an adult, but all of them are like, yo, let's put avocado and ketchup. Like, this is just raw. Like, I'm an adult, okay?
Okay, I got the raw onions on there as well. Ms. Lowe, you want ketchup? Mm-hmm. All right.
Yo, chat, any sponsors on
this
video?
REI? Oh, Gavin just called out REI.
This one's sponsored by Timu.
We have forgotten a crucial, crucial ingredient. Bacon. All right, y'all, it's time to serve up Miss Lauren. We got the bacon cheeseburger. A little bit of warm bacon on top. Let's serve this up to a... Here you go, miss. Enjoy your dinner. All right, y'all. I'm going to hit mine with some salt. Hit it with a little of that. We're gonna throw some bacon on here. All right, y'all, I'm back with my bun. I've got raw onion, avocado, ketchup under there. Then I'm gonna do some ketchup and queso on this one. Oh no. Saved it, okay, we're good. Look at that. That is delicious. All right, guys, we're going to say a quick blessing for the meal here, and then we are going to get on to munching around the fire. So, dear Lord, thank you so much for this day. Thank you so much for the food. Please bless this evening as we all are hanging out together around the fire. Thanks for giving us this time as brothers and family to get together. And please just bless our relationships as we get older together. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right.
Did they do that, Hugh?
I'm going to grub on that. All right, guys, here we go.
Operation, get sticks and leaves.
Right? This thing is crazy.
One, three, break.
It was incredible.
Where is the grill?
How's the burger?
To my stash. I bought an electric.
Sup guys, after dinner, now we're just gonna be making some s'mores with some s'more sticks we made.
Spent how many minutes whittling that down to a good s'more stick?
This one probably only a couple minutes.
It's an artwork, the s'mores.
Are you frothing?
It's not just a silly old dessert, it's an artwork.
Are you frothing?
Yeah.
Who said you can't frolic in flowers?
People.
That was awesome. Wait, what? What?
So awesome.
Now, personally.
Rhythm.
All right, guys, I've got the s'more plate ready. Who's got a malo ready?
I got a malo ready.
All right, drop that malo.
All right. Ready? Pull.
Oh, that's a nice mullet. First bite. Mmm, so puffy.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
It got caught on fire.
Take me home, country roads. I hear a voice in the morning, now she calls me. Radio reminds me of my long, far way.
Take me home to the place.
I belong, West Virginia. Mount Mama.
Not so loud.
Take me home.
Right, yo, coming in. Once more, it looks like a meteorite. But hey. It's time for s'mores. If it ain't burnt to the core, it's not a s'more. Cheers.
Meets nitty gritty.
That's why. That's
not what you said.
Oh, my bad. Small town lots of world when things change. Need drum. Hearts need numb.
Boots need.
Eating this has turned into damage control.
I used to spend my nights in the ballroom.
Alright y'all, we are cleaning up everything now. We have had a few s'mores. We've talked around the fire. We are going to sleep. I'll show you the sleeping quarters in a minute when I head in there. But we're off to bed. I hope y'all have a good night's sleep. God bless y'all. We'll see you tomorrow morning after this little tent tour. Hence, this is the crib. We've got Lauren and I, Andy.
That's your job. It's like 2 a.m. I'm tired. What do you want? It's fully just like 12:05. I don't know why I lied.
Good night, y'all. We're going to bed. We'll see you all bright and early. I'm going to wake them up. John Denver, sunshine on my shoulders. You already know what's going down. They're going to hate it. See you tomorrow.
Unamused the second time around. Can I get a raise of hands? Who wants coffee this morning? One coffee, two coffees, hot chocolates. All right. Good morning, guys. Morning, everyone. We're gonna start the day off the same way we always do, by cooking up some coffee, not only for me but for everybody else. So I'm threading sticks through either side of the coffee filter here. So that's the general idea, everyone. We're gonna have the coffee grounds in there. The sticks are to keep the filter from imploding in the cup, and we're gonna fill it with grounds. Hot water's going. First time ever trying this, but I've seen on YouTube and it should work. Alright y'all, the water's boiling.
Nice.
There you go, that's why we have the sticks. It's when the filter falls in there. Here we go, guys. We got the fire, or the coffee brewing. I'm calling this the filter stick method. Drop a better name in the comments if you're even watching this. Cheers, guys. It's coffee time. Cheers. It's gonna wake you up for sure, for sure. Oh, that is the darkest roast I have had in a minute. Well, guys, quick little update. Gavin didn't pay attention to the coffee tutorial and sent it. Is this your first time making coffee in the woods?
Yep.
You're doing a good job.
Thank you.
There's always room for improvement, though.
There's always room for hot chocolate.
Cheers, y'all. Hope you enjoy whatever you're doing this morning. All right, guys, we are chilling around the fire. We are gonna get a few housekeeping things in order. We're gonna start packing up just a tiny bit. Then next, we'll catch you guys around the skillet, or the griddle, whatever you wanna call it. And we're gonna chef up something delicious for breakfast. In the South, I heard they say deli shoes. That's how I would describe this one right here. Stick with it. Thanks so much for watching, guys, on this family camping trip. We'll see you guys at breakfast time. All right, guys, so you know what time it is. It's time not to be animals in the bush. It's time to do our dish. But I couldn't find any lambs here. So we're gonna do an experiment here. We're gonna use pine thistle or pine green ends to just give it a little scrub down. I feel like it's gonna, oh, it already is working good. One clean enough pan to cook on. All right, guys, welcome back to my bush kitchen here. We've got our ingredients, everything we're gonna need for breakfast today. I'm gonna tell you the ingredients, you can guess what we're making, I'm gonna tell you at the end. So first we got some bacon from pre-cooked from the other day. These are all eggs, butter, breakfast sausages slash lunch sausages, we'll see. Loaf of bread, backup waffles. These are the two biggest hints right here. We've got South American vanilla extract, McCormick ground cinnamon. Place your guesses in the comments. We are making my family's world famous French toast. So we're making kind of like an egg bath for the toast. That's what makes it French toast. I don't know how else to explain it, but keep watching. Let's see what we're doing. Cinnamon, South American, what is it? Vanilla Mayan Gold. Brought along some almond milk here. When you bring some almond milk, or any type of milk for that matter, it makes it fluffier, makes it lighter. It's overall more delicious. So there's some almond milk. All right, y'all, so we've got the batter done. Next up, we're gonna finish brewing beverages on the Coleman. Then we're gonna activate the griddle and start frying up this French toast. Thanks for joining me in the kitchen, guys. Hope you enjoy. All right, y'all, welcome into my bush kitchen here. We're gonna start on the French toast. I've never made French toast before. It's pretty easy. This is my fifth or sixth time making it, and I've already mastered it, according to the people who eat it. Take bread, remember that egg sauce thing that we made, we're gonna dip it a little bit on both sides, you know what I'm saying? Drip it and plop it. We're gonna repeat that process for this entire loaf of bread, and at the end of it, we're gonna have 10 or 12 golden, crispy, delicious, buttery slices of French toast. Number four, flip and drip. Cheers, guys. Number one. So yeah, guys, this is the easiest way I know to make French toast. I can drop the recipe in the comment section below. Hope y'all enjoy. We'll catch you guys when it's all plated and ready to eat.
Is that the whole loaf of bread?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
Order up, sir. Enjoy. Actually, let's pray real quick.
Dear Lord, thank you so much for this food. Thank you so much for this outing. Please bless this food for our bodies. Thanks for all this time we get to spend with our brothers today. Thank you for orchestrating the perfect campsite. Thank you for orchestrating everything perfectly. Please bless this food to our bodies. Please bless this rest of the day to our family. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 All right. Grub time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's nice. Grace not approved.
All right, guys. Little bit of a change of plans. A little more like a curveball. We ran out of bread. We brought backup waffles. I was just going to cook these like regular waffles, but we have enough egg wash. Let's make waffle French toast.
Same thing, we're just plopping them in there.
Finished making the breakfast, check that out. Have you ever seen a waffle French toast before? Bloody gorgeous. On some regular plates. There's the plating. We said grace. Lord bless this food one more time. And that sausage is going on the griddle now. I'm turning into a bloody feed. Thanks for watching, guys. Appreciate it. Comment down below if you have a favorite breakfast item slash breakfast camping item. For myself, it's going to be I eat fried eggs almost every morning. Eggs and toast, scrambled eggs, something like that. And this has to be by far my favorite camping meal, French toast. Because chow down on French toast and syrup, but you're also getting a lot of protein because it's coated in egg. So after just talking to the comment section, it made me think a little bit. To all of my friends and family who are watching, and I know that half of the people watching this are my friends and I've taken them camping and the other half is my grandparents, so either of you guys, comment below what your favorite camping trip has been and the location that you went to. I'm curious to try to cross off some places on the map. This place is called Lover's Leap. It's absolutely gorgeous. It looks like Yosemite. This is in Northern California, right next to South Lake Tahoe. This is one of my favorite campsites. So this is the first California mission we've done on this channel, which has been super cool. Super cool to cross off new states on the map. But yeah, let me know if you guys have any favorite camping spots, because I know the boys and I have hit Arizona a ton of times, and especially Northern Arizona and Sedona. So we're thinking about maybe Utah or Colorado, or even Nevada. So let me know if you guys have any preferences on that, as well as any experience in that area. I would love to get your feedback and I'd love to hear about it. Thanks, guys. Comment below.
Cheers, y'all. Some good coffee right there. It's dark.
I'm not gonna show you anything else, but
just listen to that. Of course, I got y'all ready right here. Say what's up.
Whole plate.
Want me to start?
Yeah, you start, I finish.
All right. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Please help that I was sick and feel better. Thank you for bringing us all together here and in your nature. Please help this food nourish our bodies and help that we have safe travels up to Tahoe and back home.
Yeah, thank you, Lord, for this meal. Thank you for the time that we've gotten to spend with my brothers. Thank you for clearing all of our schedules. That's a miracle in of itself. Lord, I want to take a quick moment and pray for anybody who's possibly watching this, that first and foremost, that they may find light in their own life through you, and that you may help send people to share the gospel for them. And if it's through me, Lord, then thank you for choosing me. I just want to pray for everybody at home, that they may have full bellies and good night's sleeps and health among them and their families. Lord, thank you for having your hand on everyone who watches and everyone who doesn't. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. It's hot.
They already ate, but it's time for me to grub on some French toast now. Waffle French toast.
I'm gonna do a mock draft.
Smile. Gavin.
Time to do some more dishes. Thank you.
All right, guys, it is that time. Camp is officially packed up. We just need to break down the tent and shuffle it all to the car. Lovers Leap, thank you so much. Lord, thank you for making this possible. Give you guys the scenery. There you have it, guys. We are done camping at Lover's Leap. We're gonna meet you guys at the next location involving water, snorkel masks, and crawfish. Thanks for sticking with us. We'll see you soon.